Writing a nonfiction report book. I can teach others about a topic I know a lot about by writing a report. Today we're going to focus on two essential questions: how are reports organized, and how do report authors make their books engaging so others want to read them? It's sunny where they are. Tall trees rise above green fields. People are lounging in the sun, right by the river. Somebody puts a cup in the river and takes a sip. Somebody reaches up to a tree, grabs the branch, and begins to eat it. Oh wait, did I mention this is about Candyland, where everything is candy? I guess I forgot that. I probably should have said that at the beginning. That's what we call an introduction. An introduction is a section at the beginning of a nonfiction text that tells the readers what they're going to be learning about. This way, when you learn all the information, it all comes together and makes sense because you know the main idea, what the book is mostly about. Let's look at a few nonfiction authors and see how they wrote an introduction to their books, while we think about how we can write an introduction to our own nonfiction books. Let's start with this book, all about environment, a world of change. The introduction is always at the very beginning of the book, the first section. Counting on change. Some people say that change is the only thing that stays the same. In this world, change is something we can count on. What is here today may be gone tomorrow, or if it is not gone, it may not be the same. Day becomes night, seeds become plants, food becomes waste, and you grow up and become an adult. Yes, you can count on it. Change is here to stay. In this introduction, they taught us a little bit about change, but they didn't give away all the specific details. We'll learn more about how nature changes in the rest of the book, but in the introduction, we just talked about change. That's the main idea, or what the book is mostly about. Let's check out this book about pyramids. The first section is called Great Pyramids. This one's a read aloud if you want to look at it on Epic. What is topped with a point and reaches way up high? What is built from stone with room for a mummy inside? A pyramid. What did you notice about the way this author hooked their reader and helped them keep reading? This author chose to start their introduction with a riddle. They were just letting us know that in this book, we're going to be learning all about pyramids. Let's look at a book about a country. Let's try this one about South Africa. I see in this introduction to this country, South Africa, they have a map of South Africa. An important aspect of learning about a country is knowing where it is in the world. So maybe that would be a good thing to include in a nonfiction book about a country. This introduction starts with the heading, Welcome to South Africa. Waves splash onto the white sand beach. Surfers look for the next big wave. Children run into the sea. Beach umbrellas shade people from the bright sun. It is summer in South Africa and the beaches are busy. Could you close your eyes and picture it? That was a really descriptive introduction. Usually in nonfiction texts, we use specific and factual information. We want to make sure that our adjectives are really specific. But sometimes in the beginning of a nonfiction text, in the introduction, when you're trying to hook your reader, you might try to paint a picture for them more like you would for a fiction book. This way, they can really get excited about what they're reading. Now let's try to write our own introduction to a nonfiction book. This is my book all about Vietnam. Over here, I have my notes just in case. Now, as I said, the introduction usually goes in the beginning of the book. But if you're writing in Book Creator, it can be a little bit tricky to do that. No worries, we can still do it. I'm going to go to the end of my book, and I'm going to add a new page. I can add my heading. Right now, I'll just call it Introduction, but maybe I'll come up with a better title later. Ooh, maybe instead we could say, Welcome to Vietnam. I kind of liked that idea. It feels like our readers are traveling somewhere, but your heading can be anything you want. Now I'm going to add another text box for the introduction. How should I start? I really want to hook my readers, and also I just want to tell them that they're going to be learning about Vietnam. Maybe I'll try to describe Vietnam in detail. Let me check my notes and see what I remember about Vietnam. Ooh, I remember people play a lot of sports. There might be puppet shows on water. Ooh, there's lots of delicious food. I remember that in nonfiction books, we usually like to use specific and factual adjectives. And delicious isn't really that factual. It can be different to everybody. But in an introduction, when I want to hook my reader, I think I can use more exciting words like delicious and beautiful, because then it'll get people feeling really excited and positive and they just want to read more. Maybe I'll start with Welcome to Vietnam. Vietnam is a country in Asia. There, I told the basic fact about Vietnam that we might want to learn when we're reading the introduction. It's a country and it's in Asia. Then they'll learn more in the rest of the sections, but how am I going to hook them? Well, maybe I'll describe all of the amazing parts of Vietnam, like the beautiful landscape. Vietnam has beautiful mountains, rivers, and waterfalls to see. What else could I tell them as I'm painting my picture of Vietnam? Ooh, there is delicious food. I see here I have my section all about food. There is delicious food, lively celebrations, and fascinating people. And now I have to end with a way that invites my readers to read more. I mean, I could just end there. That's a pretty strong introduction as it is. Or I could end by saying, let's explore Vietnam. Maybe let's explore all that Vietnam. Can be a little bit tricky to write an introduction, and that's okay. It's okay to delete things and go back and change them. This is editing and revising. Let's explore Vietnam. Great. And now they'll be ready to read the rest of the book. I've introduced the topic. They know what we're going to read about, those readers. And now we're ready to teach more. One last thing I want to show you before you go write is that you can change the order of the pages to make your introduction first. If you click on this button, Pages, I can take my introduction and I can drag it up to the top right after the cover. That way, my introduction is the first section, as it usually is. Now it's your turn. What are you going to say in your introduction? Oh, one more thing I forgot to tell you. This might be a good time to include a map of your country if you're writing a book about a country. I'll import a picture and I can write Vietnam map. Let's see what we can find. Oh, and here are some maps of Vietnam. I can scroll down to see if anything is really popping out to me. This one looks pretty good. I'll select that map of Vietnam. Make it a little bit smaller so it fits. And there we go, a map of Vietnam and my introduction. Happy writing!